Hi, everybody. As they say, it's 5 o'clock somewhere. And you know, I love wine. It's so delicious and romantic. But you know what? It doesn't love me. In fact, alcohol doesn't love anybody's body. It's so unhealthy for us. It's really hard on our liver. It's hard on our heart. It gives us high blood pressure. It ages us. I don't like that. And it's just not the greatest thing. So, Garden of Edie, to the rescue. I created this delicious blended wine knot. Because why not have something that tastes so delicious, that's so healthy for you, that looks like wine and kind of tastes like it, but no alcohol. And you will get high on life when you drink this delicious wine knot, hibiscus, and wild blueberry drink. You get some dried hibiscus tea leaves, and we're gonna pour hot boiling water on it, and we're gonna let it sit for about 20, 25 minutes. Then we're gonna strain it, and I'm gonna show you how we're gonna finish this wine knot recipe. I know you're all thinking, but wine is vegan, it's plant-based. Well, technically it is, and so are Oreos, and so are French fries, and so are a lot of processed foods that just really aren't healthy for us. So it is not a whole food. And at Garden of Edie, we are focused on every time we put something in our mouth, we're doing something great for our body. That's the way to look at it. And with this recipe, we are doing so many great things. Hibiscus tea is filled with antioxidants. It lowers your blood pressure. It has all these properties that are so helpful. In fact, when I used to have high blood pressure, I started drinking the hibiscus tea. But once I became plant-based and drank the hibiscus tea, my blood pressure is perfect now. Also included in this recipe is this Wineman's Wild Blueberry Juice. It is so rich in antioxidants too. They both do pretty much the same thing. You know, when you drink colors or eat colors that are vibrant and deep, you know they have all these polyphenols and all these things that are helpful for the body, from your brain to your kidneys, to your liver, to your heart, to the cells and tissues in your entire body. So it's a good thing. And lastly, we're gonna put a little honey in this. And honey, I get the ones that are local to my area. And it's so delicious and so helpful as well. Antioxidants and all the good things. But I wanna show you a tip. This recipe calls for 1/4 cup of honey. That adds just a little bit of sweetness. And what I like to do is run super, super, super hot water on the little measuring cup. And what that does is, once you put the honey in there, it just releases it so easily. And that's all it takes. And then I'm gonna pour a little bit of, I poured the water out. I'm gonna put 1/4 cup. And look, I'm gonna put it in with the blueberry juice. I might not do all the whole quarter. I might just do like 3 tablespoons, because sometimes it just seems sweeter than other times. So if we need to add more, we'll certainly do that. Okay, it's been about 20, 25 minutes, and you really do want this hot water to sit on those hibiscus tea leaves for quite some time, because the longer it sits, kind of the richer and richer and more delicious it gets and really infuses the water. So I'm gonna go ahead and strain it now. It's a nice, rich red. Remember, this is that wild blueberry juice and 3 tablespoons of honey. So it's still a little warm. Now I'm gonna refrigerate it and get it nice and cold. And then we will have some wine knot celebration. Well, the wine knot has chilled and it's ready to pour. Why not make it festive and put it in a decanter, even though it does not need decanting. It doesn't need aging. It just needs drinking. As you can see, it actually looks like red wine. Let's smell the bouquet, shall we? I smell hibiscus. I smell a little wild blueberry, but when you taste it, it kind of tastes like wine. And you know how everyone toasts, "Here's to your health"? Well, here's really to your health.